Good morning, everybody. Now let us come to the next topic of the chapter, that is, how were states formed? Now, in the year 1920s, Indian National Congress was the major party. Indian National Congress at that time promised that if India becomes independent, we will make linguistic groups into different provinces. That means new states will be created on the basis of languages. But when India became independent, the Congress did not fulfill its promise. They did not honor or respect the promise made to the people. The main reason for this was that because when India became independent, India was divided on the basis of religion. A new state called Pakistan was created on the basis of religion, and there were riots between Hindus and Muslims in which more than 1 million people died. So the Prime Minister and the Deputy Prime Minister, that is Jawaharlal Nehru and Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, they said that India has just now gone through a severe riot, and India cannot afford to have another riot if India is divided on the basis of language. So they were reluctant to divide India on the basis of language. So freedom has come at that time. Though a lot of efforts were made by Gandhiji to keep the Hindus and the Muslims united, but the freedom came as not one religion but as two nations, and in riots more than 1 million people were killed. So that's why Prime Minister and Deputy Prime Minister were not in favor of dividing the country on the basis of language. In the speech given by Jawaharlal Nehru, he said that the need of India is to make India a united nation, and any force which will foster nationalism or which will help in the growth of nationalism should go forward, and anything which stops nationalism should be rejected. So according to him, division of nation on the basis of language can create problem. But when this decision came from the side of the government, or when the states were not divided on the basis of language, so there were many groups of people who felt very disappointed. Especially the Kannada speaking people, Malayalam speaking people and the Marathi speaking people, they were looking forward for a new separate state. So these people became very disappointed, and the strongest protest came from the side of the Telugu speaking people. These Telugu speaking people were under Madras presidency, and they wanted a separate state for themselves, and they don't want to be under the Madras presidency. So when Jawaharlal Nehru once went to Madras presidency for a campaign for general election, which was to be held in 1952, the people of Telugu speaking people, they greeted him with black flags and protest, and they demanded that we want Andhra. One of a veteran leader or a Gandhian who belonged to this Telugu speaking area, so his name was Putti Sriramulu, he went on hunger strike on behalf of the Telugu speakers for a separate nation for Telugu people. So he went on strike, he sat on the strike, and there were many protest movements and hartals and strikes going on all over Madras presidency. When this Putti Sriramulu was under hunger strike, so after 58 days of fast, Sriramulu died. So his death created widespread anger among the Telugu speakers, and he died on 15th December 1952, and the whole Andhra was in chaos, and the protests which were already going on, those protests became widespread and very intense. So ultimately the government government has to give in. The government was forced to accept the demands of the Telugu speakers, and so it was decided that on 1st October 1953, a new state of Andhra was created, which later on became Andhra Pradesh. So the first state which was created after independence was Andhra Pradesh. Slowly, slowly, other linguistic communities also started demanding for separate state. So for that, a commission was made, which was called a State Reorganization Commission, which was set up, and it submitted its report to the government in the year 1956. And according to that recommendations, it was decided that the districts and the provincial boundaries will be redrawn, and small, that is compact provinces will be given to Assamese speaking people, Bengali, Oriya, Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada and Telugu speaking people. So this state reorganization committee decided to give separate states to these language speaking people. Apart from that, all North India was full of Hindi speaking people, but even then North India will be divided into small states. Apart from that, in 1960 it was decided that Bombay, which was in which two language peoples, language speaking people were there, they were Gujaratis and Marathis, so the bilingual state of Bombay was divided into two states. One was given to Marathi speaking people and one for Gujarati speaking people. Then in 1966, Punjab was also divided. So that province of Punjab was divided into Punjab and Haryana. The Punjabi speaking people, especially Sikhs, went to Punjab, and those who were Haryanvi speaking people, which was more or less the same as Hindi, so they went to another state, that is Haryana. So in this way, so many states were divided and a new state was created. Many new states.